emakhosini. Ngiyasithoka phambi kwenu nina nonke emakhaya naphambi kwami athongo namadlozi. Mkhuluseda lo, igedla lamashkrishkr, inyanga yamakhosi. And I welcome you guys back to another episode of Kemi TV, man. I love you guys. I'm back on another episode. I'm back trying to be consistent. I know I receive a lot of complaints. Sometimes you keep on my video, sometimes I'll keep on my video. Angijabule neze, neze, ngoba ngithanda ukubuka. Sengibuyile, we'll be dropping much more content in the days to come. But I welcome you guys to another episode of Kemi TV. Yeah, yilo leli mani igedla lamashkrishkr. Namhlanje bakwethu, as you've seen from the thumbnail, we're doing something light. I think the last episode was a bit intense. Had a lot of information, but I do hope it was helpful to most of you. Today we are going to be covering dreams that are warning signs, not only warning signs from amadlozi, from your ancestors, but warning signs from your guardian angels. Not only dreams but signs and omens that show ukuthi lalela ungalaleli usencupheni noma ulaka lwethu uyothola njengenqindi ebusweni. Warning signs as well from God. When God is trying to readjust your direction, readjust the direction of your life to the path that is your soul chosen path. Most of phumile endleleni ukuthi bekumele ube umfundisi mara manje wena usuy groovist of note. Unkulunkulu athi buya ngaphambi kokuthi uthole alcohol poisoning. Today we're going to be covering dreams, signs and omens which come from God, the angels and your ancestors. It's just not inqaba gula bakwethu. I don't want this episode to go long because there's a lot of points that we have to cover, a lot of dreams that I have to cover. So I'll be moving quick. So anything that I don't cover, any dream that I don't cover amongst this long list of dreams, you hit me up on the comment section. Just as a side note, a lot of you might not be happy with this announcement, but I have to make it due to the influx of messages that come in, and most of them being dream interpretation requests, by which we will now need inkanyiso of 50 rand to interpret a bulk of dreams. If you're coming with 3 dreams, whether you're coming with 5 dreams, but maximum don't let it be more than 8 dreams, you must ukhanyise nge 50 rand. This is because my business WhatsApp is flooded and I am not able to manage it and manage sometimes messages coming from patients that I'm supposed to be answering. So nani nekhaya ningixolele uma nithi niyangifonela, uma nithi niyangitexta ningakhoni ukungithola ku-business WhatsApp. It's because it's so busy, it overwhelms me sometimes. Sometimes I'm out, I'm not able to be on business WhatsApp. So kuzodingeka inkanyiso specifically for dream interpretations. If uzofuna ukuthi ngihlaziye amaphupho 50 rand bakwethu, this is as well ukuthi nami ngikhona ukusebenza, ngisebenze in an efficient way so that I can get overwhelmed. Without ginqamagula, without further ado, dreams that are warnings from your ancestors. It's starting amaphupho aphume edlozini bakwethu. There's a lot of dreams you send through to me. And by the time umuntu I get to his dream, which at times is about 2 weeks later, at times it's about a week later, at times I take days to answer, mbone ukuthi kahle kahle umuntu usengcupheni. I hope by the time I answer them abalimalanga. So I'm just doing this video to cover so that if you watch it and you've had this dream, you don't have to contact me. I've already covered you, okay? Dreams that are warning signs from ancestors. Please be aware, if a dream keeps repeating itself, a bad dream, even if it's not covered here, reach out to me, ukhanyise, and let's interpret that dream, because a dream repeating itself is a very dangerous dream. Iphupho lokulibuya libuya libuya njengoba linjalo iphupho elini. Lelo phupho lisuke selixwayisa. So it's not good to ignore it. Because dreams are messages from the angels, from God, from your ancestors. So you must be aware of that. Ungathathi nje ukuthi amaphupho nje amaphupho, they're psychological. Unganangqondo yiwo umcabango wakho lowo. Kodwa those that understand that above the physical realm lies the ethereal realm of your soul, the world of dreams and mental forms. When you understand that, you understand where dreams come from. to dream of fire, bakwethu. To dream of fire, to dream whether you are on fire, to dream whether things around you are on fire. Ukubona umlilo, especially izinto zakho zisha noma wena usha. Usho ulaka lwamadlozi, it is the anger of the ancestors. You must go consult to find out ukuthi bakwatiswe yini, yini bengayenzwanga. Bayikwatele, either they angry at you or bakwatele abantu basekhaya. That's what that dream would mean. To dream of dogs chasing you or biting you lightly. Azikulimazi, kodwa ziyakuluma. Ziyagijimisa. Generally, it would mean ukuthi idlozi liyakufuna. For whatever purpose, ithongo liyakufuna. They are looking for you and wena utholakale. Ukuthi uhambile, uyagibhida noma kwenze njani, ithongo liyakufuna. Uma ulumwa izinja, sebakufuna, sebakwatile, bafuna ukudonsa ukuthi ubuye. Because kunomlayezo ongawutholi noma kunento ongayenzi abayicelayo. Something they are wishing for you to do, but you are not doing it. Ukuphupha amanzi angcolile, to dream of dirty water, or to dream of dirty water coming into the house. Ukuphupha amanzi angcolile angena endlini, noma ukuphupha ubona amanzi angcolile. Lokho is indicative of either umsamo odinga ukugeza, ugezwa, noma is indicative or trying to tell you ukuthi isimo sasendlini asilunganga. Either kuphehlwa amanzi amnyama, noma ikhaya kumele ligezwe, noma wena kumele uyogezwa. That's what that would mean, dreaming of dirty water. Dreaming of yourself eating meat. This has two interpretations, okay? Dreaming of red meat, specifically inyama ebovu. To dream of yourself eating red meat either means uzogula, and it's not going to be a light sickness. You're going to become very sick, or uzoshona. If you dream of ukuthi kune-braai noma kosiwa inyama ebovu noma kuphekwa inyama ebovu ekhaya, it means kuzoba nesifo ekhaya noma khona umuntu oyogulela noma alimalele ukufa ekhaya. To dream of yourself being chased by a violent bull. Lelo ikhehle elikhulu lelo. Lelo idlozi elikhulu elakini liyakufuna. It's either you've done something that has pissed them off, or your family is not paying attention, and then you, unfortunately, are the chosen one. Ukuthi leyo nkomo noma leyo bhuli ikulande izodila nawe. Izodila nawe ukuthi yenze example to the family ukuthi ngikwatile. Leli khehle elikhulu, ithonga elikhulu, or rather in fact ithingathi ithonga elikhulu, umkhulu omkhulu ophethe umsamo noma the head of your family looking for you. If it's chasing you, good. If say I'm shy, not good. Hambohlola ndoda. Hambohlola ungaze ulimale. To dream of yourself being given a hiding, irregardless of ukuthi ubani okushayayo, specifically if it's one of your elder relatives, abogogo, abomkhulu, your aunts, abomamncane, to dream of umama or ubaba giving you a hiding. This is itongo punishing. There's something you're not doing right. This is idlozi punishing you. Khona into ongayenzi ngendlela. Bazokushaya. And bazokushaya ukuthi bakubuyise endleleni. Either if usuphupha bakushaya, there's things already going wrong in your life. And then they're trying to tell you ukuthi yithi, we are giving you a hiding because awulalele ihlomandlela. So now we are giving you a hiding, ubuyise endleleni. This is also a warning from the ancestors ukuthi there is punishment for something you have done that you thought you got away with. So vuke maqandeni, go catch your DP, bro. Go catch your disciplinary. Dreaming of being robbed or losing money. Bakwethu, this is a serious dream. Abaningi abeni abangakhumbula amaphupho mangithi ngiyababhula. When I start doing my readings, there's a few of you that have come, and when I spoke of this nafuma nathi yebo mkhulu kunjalo, ngikhuphe ngigijimisa amaphara, ngibanjwe inkunzi, ngilahlekelwa imali. Ngifuna ukuthi wazi ukuthi if this is happening, khona la inhlanhla yakho ichitheka khona. It'll either be the case ukuthi unikezana ngemali kakhulu to people whom you should not be spending inhlanhla yakho with. And so idlozi izama ukukutshela, your ancestors are trying to tell you that you should not be spending money with these people. We don't want inhlanhla yethu ichithekela phezu kwalabantu laba. Or it could be ukuthi uthunyelwa ngesilwane ukuthi iy'nhlanhla zakho zithwetshulwe. In some way or form, khona umuntu ozama ukuthwebula imali yakho. I know from personal experience, I used to have dreams like that. Uphupha umuntu afika kuwe azoboleka imali, umnika imali. That is not a good dream. In a dream, you should never be giving money away. You should never ever be losing money or getting robbed. It is indicative of inkaka echithekayo, either by your own hand or by the hand of midnight engineers. Dreaming of a car crashing or a car being stuck. Now, a car has two interpretations. Imoto inencazelo ezithu. Uma sihlaziya iphupho lomuntu ohamba ngemoto, sike sibheke ukuthi imoto, what color is that car? And sike sibheke ukuthi what condition is that car? So, if you are dreaming of yourself crashing or your car is stuck, a car is indicative of progress because a car takes you from A to B. So, uma uphupha imoto, it's indicative of spiritual progress or life progress in general. So, if ihamba kahle, that would mean that things are going well, bajabulile ngawe, bakhambise indleleni eziqondile. But if you dream of it crashing, that is either a warning ukuthi le ndlela oyihambayo angeke iphele kamnandi. If you dream of it stuck, that means umile. There is izinto ezidingakalayo ukuthi uqondise yona impilo yakho, whether spiritually or physically, ukuze izinto zizoqhubekela phambili. I do hope I covered that thoroughly. Ukuphupha i-toilet, ukuphupha indlu yangasese, ukuphupha ukaka, ukuphupha uchama, isichitho. Ayijiki, ayibheki kwenye indawo. Isichitho, hamba uyogezwa, hamba uyo-checkwa, khona umuntu okuphonsa ngesichitho ukuthi achithe izinto zakho. Ukuziphupha umithi. Abanye, now, there are some cases, rare cases, where umuntu azophupha amithi, umuntu azophupha akhulelwe. And in those cases, some few cases, they are really pregnant. But generally, amaphupha about pregnancy would be ukuthupha ithelo, ukuphupha amaveji, ukuphupha kulinywa, ukuphupha kudla ama-fruit. Izinto ezinjalo njalo zizokhomba ukuthi umithi ukhulelwe. Kodwa generally, ukuphupha umithi kushuthi uneslwane umuntu wesifazane ekumele sikhishwe. Kushuthi ulaliswe nento ekufake isilwane and ekumele leso silwane sikhishwe. Hlungu, but I hope it gets to the right people. Ukuphupha udutshulwa noma ugwazwa, ushaywa ngemithi. Ngiyakuspose abathakathi. If uphupha umuntu omaziyo agwaza noma akudubula, loyo muntu ombonayo usuke akushaya ngomuthi akuthakathe, futhi ayibheki kwenye indawo. Injalo nje. Ukuphupha ungqunu, uma uphupha ungqunu as well, it also means ukuthi uyathakathwa. Noma it could mean ukuthi khona umuntu okukhuluma kabi, khona umuntu okuhlebayo emva kwakho. At that present moment or on that day, khona umuntu bekakhuluma kabi. That's what dreaming of being naked could be. Now, Nina Benu, I want you to be careful because some of you are nebosana. Nizophupha ningqo. Sometimes it's not the case ukuthi ukhulunywa kapi yathakathaka. Sometimes it's ukuthi nebosana. Abantu abanebosana bavamise ukuziphupha bangqono, noma basiphuphe bagqoke impahla ezimnyama, bacabanga ukuthi ngifakwe isinyama, ngiyathakathwa, kodwa cha, impilo sasebusuku. Dreaming of yourself sleeping with someone you don't know. Isilwane. It's a spiritual wife or a spiritual husband. It cannot be anything else. It does happen with at times you dream of yourself uleli nomuntu wakini, uleli maybe with somebody you know. This could be psychological, this could be a message from idlozi, this could be idlozi likulethela inhlanhla. Sometimes ukuphupha uleli nomuntu wakini, sometimes is idlozi lizembathe with that person's image, likulethela inhlanhla. But generally, if umuntu ongamazi, yazi ukuthi khehla lamakhehla bayakudavaza ebusuku. Abakudedeli, bayakuqeda, bayacindezela ntombazane, or wena ndoda ucindezela isilwane, uyasho ukuthi ntanga, mina ngiyaqeda ngapha, ngiyagadla. Uyasho ukuthi dog, mina ngiyagadla ngapha, kanti hayi, kahle imfene, it's child, bro. So, It's not good. It's not a good thing ukuthi uphuphe ulala nomuntu ongamazi. Ukuphupha amaphoyisa akufuna. The ancestors are looking for you. Amaphoyisa noma amasosha amadlozi wakini adila mayelana ukukulwela nokukuvikela. But if you dream of them looking for you or them arresting you, shuthi khona into engahambanga kahle, ongayenzanga kahle, noma into ekumele uyenze and bayakufuna bayakubiza. If you have that dream in general, go emsamo uyophahla. Usho emadlozini ukuthi ngizwile ukuthi niyangifuna madoda. Kwenze njani zalukazi? Ishona ukuthi ikuphi ekushodayo engakwenzanga noma ikuphi, ikuphi la engayenzanga ngendlela. It's generally doesn't mean ukuthi you're in trouble, it just means your ancestors are looking for you. Unless bagijimisa, kushuthi you are on the run. Bantwana bomoya, nina eniphupha amaphoyisa enezipho, kushuthi you are on the run, nibalekele izipho zenu and bayanifuna. Makhosi. To dream of yourself wearing dirty clothes, ibhadi. Ukusiphupha ugqoke impahla ezidabukile, ukusiphupha ugqoke impahla ezingcolile, ibhadi, kushuthi wembethwe ibhadi. Generally, people who will have dreams like that will shortly start seeing things going wrong in their life. Or things are definitely not going correct. Shuthi wembethwe ibhadi, whether it's through ubuthakathi or whether it's through your own hands, kumele uhambe uyogezwa, kumele uhambe uyohlolwa, ukuthi uhlolisiswe ukuthi hey, le bhadi le lingibathe kwenzenjani, because I thought I was a smooth criminal, kanti wahamba walala nombali, kanti umbali unesinyama, na wathola isinyama. Of course. So, check that dream. It's not a good dream. Dreaming of a snake biting. This is a sign ukuthi khona umuntu ofuna ukushaya umuntu ozokuqeda. Umthakathi. That snake is umthakathi, the midnight engineer ofuna ukuqeda ngawo. Because when a snake bites you, venom is lethal. It's not like when somebody stabs or shoots you, which you could survive. Snake bite is lethal. Kushuthi khona umthakathi oqondane nawo. So, go protect yourself, uqiniswe, uqatshwe, gezwe, ufake inkambo, ukuthi umthakathi makathi one, ngishayele, umthakathi bayashaywa kwakwethu, ayashaywa umthakathi akaxolelwa. You must destroy a midnight engineer. There is nothing more fun than destroying a midnight engineer. Yikho into emnandi njengokubona umthakathi sekaqhuka ngoba ungiphikisele ngenduku. So nawe, if uphuphe inyoka, siphindisele, ungacabanga ithuba. Dreaming of frogs and related creatures. Ukuphupha amaxoxo noma oqhamu noma amphibious creatures or lizard-like creatures. Especially moyibona iphupheni and lelo phuphe uyalibona nawe uyezwa intuitively ukuthi ungcola kodwa la. This is dirty. If ubona into enjalo, uma uphupha into enjalo uyazi ukuthi usuke either uthunyelwe ngokugula. Or uzogula. You are either being sent sickness spiritually or you are being warned by amadlozi ukuthi you are going to become sick very soon. Either it's a curse to make you sick or you are going to become sick either by your own hand or you are going to become sick just because you are going to become sick. So you're being warned so that you know when you become sick that, hey, I knew this was going to happen. I'm dreaming of yourself on your periods. Dreaming of yourself on your periods, it can mean two things. It can mean ukuthi uzogula. In fact, it can mean three things. It can mean ukuthi uzogula, kodwa lokho kugula bazama ukukhipha amadlozi. It could mean ukuthi unesilwane and lesilwane bazama ukusikhipha. Or it could mean ukuthi unento ekumele ikhishwe, isetshenzwe, ihlanjululwe ngaphakathi kwakho. Those are the three interpretations of that dream. Dreaming of heavy rain and wind. Ulaka lwamadlozi. You must never dream of a terrible storm. Heavy winds. Yazi ukuthi ushubile. Amadlozi have had enough with your delinquency. Sebayakufuna, abafunele ukuthi bakhulume manje, bafunele ukushaya. Laba thola khona bazokushaya because of ulaleli. So dreaming of that means exactly that. Ukuthi yeyi kuthungi yoshweleza ngaphambi kokuthi imvula ingene endlini. Dreaming of a relative not talking to you. Especially umuntu wakini owashona. Ukumphupha akudubile abuyele angakhulumisi. Kushuthi uflathelwe idlozi. shuthi khona okwenzile noma khona bebacelile wena owakuziba wazama wakuyenza, and so now sebakuflathele now, they're turning their back on you. So kumele ubuyele uncene nangidlozi like yo your girlfriend, uthi please just give me one more chance, don't be angry at me. Dreaming of an owl or black cat, ha! Ow! Because yeah, midnight engineers, I am now exposing the forms that the closes used to expose your mind. But where to napupa is cover, no man napupa a black cat. No, ukuthi loyo umthakathi. Nakanjani, nakanjani. And generally, you will see that, and then leyonto izosiphendula in a dream, and you will see someone. Shuthi leyo leso sikhova noma lelo gadi uye loyo mthakathi. You don't see midnight engineer can be anyone. Abahambi bahamba banqunu bafufa ngama-love ground. Cha, ngisho nani bomama basemasontweni, ngisho nani ninabobaba basemasontweni, nani bafundisi. Ngiyazi ukuthi some of you are midnight engineers. Nani baprofeti enizenze ngathi ngabaprofeti bokukhanya kanti ngabantu bey'mpande zenyama. So nobody is ever somebody you cannot suspect. Anybody can be a midnight engine. God. Dreaming of a wedding. Woof. I put this one last in my bowl because to dream of a wedding, of yourself getting married or somebody else getting married, simple, it's death. And the IG, abasho uthi mayivimba, bayatshela uthi loyo muntu noma wena usuyahamba emhlabeni. So start sorting out life insurance, start sorting out life policies because your bonds are broke. So we've covered that. I hope I covered those quick enough. Whatever I missed, now messages from your angels. In this case, I want to cover synchronicities because generally these dreams that I've covered would be messages ezindluliswa yithunywa and guardian angels to your ancestors, but then your ancestors will come and give you these dreams in these omens or these signs, in these dreams, in these signs. But now, if an angel is communicating with you directly, for those of you sometimes who don't understand dream interpretation, who come from other cultures, I know it's not only people who understand African spirituality who watch Kemi TV. Some of you are people that are just mainly focused on universal spirituality. We are going to have an episode where we cover synchronicities and angel numbers in depth. But for now, if you are seeing number 666, of course everybody thinks that's a bad number, right? But in this case, we're talking about it in synchronicity, not being related to the Bible. We are talking about it with regards to synchronicity. If you are seeing the number 666, you must know ukuthi 6 is fall short of the spiritual number 7. So the number 6 is interconnected with the flesh. So what the angels are trying to tell you is nciphisa kancane in terms of fleshly things. In fact, I nciphisa kancane your road on fleshly things, ukuphuza, ukulala nabafazi, ukwenza lokhu, has come to an end. You must now transcend to 777, which is the spiritual number that is indicative of alignment and luck from your guides. They are trying to tell you, Wuti, whatever now you are doing is no longer serving you physically. If you're with a girl and you see the number 666, they're trying to tell you, Guti, this is no longer serving you, you need to move away. If you are at a party or you're drinking and you see the number 666, this is no longer serving you, you need to move on. If you're smoking crystal meth for your druggies, see the number 666, that is no longer serving you. And generally, it's a warning, Guti, if you keep on, next time, sizobonisa ngokuthi uphuze udakwe ushayiswe imoto. And another number that you would see would be the number 999. Now, this would be an omen or a guidance from your angels to tell you, Ubuti, you must learn to begezela. You must learn to diligently do something until you finish it. Stop leaving things in between and then coming back and complain about why impilo yami ingahambi ngendlela. They are trying to tell you because 9 falls short of 10, which is the number of earthly completion. 9 means ukuthi you must teach yourself to complete things. You must teach yourself discipline, diligence, and continuing to do something until you get. Of course, that would be a warning as well. If you're planning on maybe quitting your job, you'll see the number 999. That's them telling you don't quit, see it through. If you are trying to start a business, but you plan on giving up, you see the number 999, your angels are telling you don't quit and try something else because that's not going to work. There's a lesson you must learn before this succeeds. Generally, your angels will speak to you through your sixth sense or your gut feeling as well. So if you find yourself around people, if you find yourself around places, and when you're doing things, you become anxious, you become paranoid, you become restless, you must know that often, more than not, it is your guardian angels trying to guide you, trying to warn you about those people, trying to warn you about those places, trying to warn you about the thing that you do. Anytime you become paranoid, you become anxious. You go out, you used to like, maybe you're going out bungee jumping and you become terribly anxious. It's them warning you, "Hey, that's not going to work out. In the long run, that's not going to go the way that you think it's going to go." You're at school, you're studying your course, but you're restless, you're anxious, you feel like this is not it. It's your guardian angels telling you, "Lento yenza uyenzise ngoba ufuna ukujabulisa abazali bakho. This is not part of your soul path. Get out of there." It is a warning sign, it is a guidance from your guardian angels. Now, as from God, sivale nje ingilosi. As from God, you must understand ukuthi bakwethu, God is in everything and in everyone. He uses anything to speak, he uses everyone to speak. So at times, if you pray, or rather if you need guidance and you have anxiety over something and awazi ukuthi why ngihlali sekhe, God is able to send someone to come advise you about something. Umuntu bengamelanga nokuthi uzofika azokutshela leyo. So teach yourself to listen to the subtle voice of God. Even umuntu ongamthanda uNkulunkulu athumile yena ukuthi azodlulisela umlayezo. God uses the ancestors and the angels to pass messages from synchronicities, dreams, omens. Uzibuza ukuthi ugogo kuphi? Vele nje inyosi, in the middle of a place where there's no flowers, God is trying to tell you, "I've sent your grandmother, your guardian angel, to watch you. She's watching you everywhere you go." God speaks through many omens, through many synchronicities, which we'll have to make a video on its own regarding God, regarding consciousness. Kodwa, you must be open to the voice of God. You must be open to the universal voice of Source, in order for you to be able to see when it's God speaking, to see when it's the devil speaking, which is ego. Ego will always serve the self. God will serve the other. Makos. I do hope this information helped you out. I want to thank all 2,000, well, approximately now, all 2,500 subscribers of Kimmy TV. Appreciate each and every one of you guys. Please continue to like, share, comment, subscribe. And yeah, I encourage each and every one of you that watch the video and you liked the content to also share and subscribe. And yeah, let's keep the channel growing. This is not my channel. Khoseda is not a damn celebrity. Khoseda is a slave to you people and to the world. So let's keep the channel growing so that we keep on serving everybody. Ngithanda ngithanda bamvela incane ngithi konke kweni makhanye ithongo lenu malinkonisele indlela hosana.